for all his experiments and to lay down the basic laws of heredity, the father of heredity, this Gregor John Mendel, chose the pea plant, the garden pea plant, or you can say edible pea plant, for all his experiments. The scientific name of this garden pea plant is Picum sativum. Remember, whenever you write a scientific name, always the genus name or the first name should be an uppercase letter, means a capital letter. And whenever you write the species name, the beginning of the species name should always start up with a lowercase letter, means a small letter. So don't forget the scientific name of garden pea plant, that is Picum sativum, because all the experiments done on Picum sativum have laid down the basic laws of heredity, have given you the concepts of heredity. So remember, the Mendel's experimental plant was Picum sativum, and this Picum sativum was chosen by Mendel based on certain advantages. So why Mendel chose pea plant? First of all, it had contrasting traits. What do you understand when I say contrasting traits? Means when I'm talking about two opposing traits in which one is dominant and the other is recessive, that pair is known as a contrasting trait, right? For example, if you take about the example, if you talk about the example of a pea plant, when you see that some flowers are white in color in case of pea plant and some flowers are violet in color in case of pea plant. So this is a pair of contrasting trait, like white flowers and violet flowers. Another example can be, if you talk about the height of the plant, the stem size of the plant, some were tall and some were dwarf. So this is a pair of contrasting trait. So by this, the pea plant executed 7 contrasting traits, which made it easy for Mendel to do all his experiments, and that is why he chose pea plant for laying down these basic laws. Let us recall all these characteristic traits, the contrasting traits. First of all, some seeds were round while some seeds were wrinkled on some plants. And if you talk about the cotyledons, some cotyledons were yellow in color, some were green in color. If you talk about the color of the flower, some plants bear white flowers and some plants bear violet colored flowers. If you talk about the color of the pods, some had yellow pods, some had green pods. Some were full, some were constricted. And if you talk about the stem size, some were long, some were dwarf. If you talk about the flowers, there were some axil flowers, and on some plants there were terminal flowers. So axil flowers are present at the axis and the terminal flowers are present at the tips, on the growing tips. So these are the pair of contrasting traits that were present in the Mendel's experimental plant. That is why Mendel chose this Picum sativum for all his experiment. Next, we move on to self-pollination. I hope you all know what is a bisexual flower. I can explain it to you. Bisexual flower is a flower in which we have all the parts, male part also and the female part also. So if you talk about what are male parts and the female parts, I mean to say about male reproductive organs and female reproductive organs. So if we have a flower, right, so we have a female part which is divided into 3. We have stigma, style and ovary. Next, the male part, we have anthers and filaments. On anthers, we have pollen grains. These pollen grains are the male gametes. And on stigma, when the pollen grains fall, they enter into the ovary and fertilization occurs. When pollination occurs on the same plant, this type of pollination is known as self-pollination. I hope that you all remember these basics. What is self-pollination? What is cross-pollination? So in this case, when the flower is bisexual, why on pea plants self-pollination was possible? Because the flowers were bisexual. They had both type of organs on the same flower. Male organs also and female organs also. So that is why this plant is known as a bisexual flower, and the self-pollination mechanism was possible on such flowers. So garden pea plant was having bisexual flowers, was bisexual. That is why self-pollination was possible. The next characteristic trait that helped Mendel to choose pea plant was artificial cross-pollination. Now, how is it possible, artificial cross-pollination? If you look at the image, I have already said that the flowers were bisexual, means they had both the reproductive organs, male also and female also. So what can Mendel do to prevent self-pollination? He needs to cross-pollinate, and how will he do cross-pollination? By artificial means. And what is that artificial means? You can see, to prevent self-fertilization, Mendel cut off the immature stamens. Stamens are the organs that produce what? Pollen grains. And pollen grains are the male gametes of the flower. So next, when he removed the stamens, he dusted on the carpel that is receiving pollen grains, pollen from some other plant, right? Whatever characteristic trait he wanted, he cross-pollinated those plants by artificial means. And this removal of anthers from the plant is known as emasculation. So remember the word emasculation. The removal of anthers from the flower is known as emasculation. So artificial cross-pollination was also easily possible by a technique that is emasculation, in which Mendel removed the anthers, or you can say the stamen part, from the flower, and he dusted the desired pollen grains on the flower so that he could achieve artificial cross-pollination. So this is another point, that is why Mendel chose pea plant. Next, this pea plant was annual, means he could get one complete generation in whole 1 year. So the annual behavior of the pea plant also helped Mendel to choose this plant. Next, it was convenient, it was easily cultivated, so that is why also Mendel chose this plant. Next, pure or true breeding plants. As you all know, what actually we mean by pure or true breeding plants, you all know that Pisum sativum is bisexual, means the flowers have both the organs, male organs also and female reproductive organs also. So this is allowing self-pollination, and due to this self-pollination, we have pure or true breeding plants. Because when there is self-pollination, always the offspring that will be produced, the progeny that will be produced, that will always be true breeding or pure. So this bisexual nature of the plant helped to produce pure or true breeding plants. That is why Mendel chose this plant. And remember the most important point, when Mendel wanted to cross-pollinate the pea plant, he followed the technique that is emasculation. What is emasculation? He removed the anthers, he removed the stamen. Stamen is the male organ, male reproductive organ of the flower, which is composed of anther and the filament, right? So he removed the stamens, or you can say he removed the anthers. That is why we are calling here as amputated anthers, means they are removed, and he dusted the desired pollen grains on the stigma of the flower so that he could get the desired traits which he wanted. So artificial cross-pollination was also easy for Mendel by a technique known as emasculation. It was achieved. That is why these are the points due to which Mendel chose pea plant as his experimental plant. So this Pisum sativum have given us the basic laws of heredity, because all the experimental work done by Mendel was on this plant. So remember why Mendel chose pea plant. Firstly, it had contrasting traits. We have discussed the 7 basic contrasting traits. For example, some plants were tall and some were dwarf. Some had yellow cotyledons, some had green cotyledons, etc., etc. Then secondly, this plant was able to self-pollinate because the flowers are bisexual, because they have both the organs. They have male part also and they have female part also. When you talk about the male reproductive organs, it is stamen. Stamen is composed of anther and filament. You all have studied in previous classes. And then we have the female part, that is stigma, style and ovules, or the ovary. What is going to happen? Since it is self-pollinating, means the pollen grains from the same flower, from the anther, are going to fall on the stigma of the same flower. This is known as self-pollination. And then fertilization is going to occur. Due to this self-pollination, the plant is going to produce pure or true breeding varieties. So this self-pollination has given advantage of pure or true breeding varieties. Next, why he chose pea plant was artificial cross-pollination, which he achieved by a technique known as emasculation, in which he removed the stamen or the anthers from the flower so that he could have a desired trait. What he did was, when he removed the immature stamens, he dusted the pollen grains of the desired trait from another flower on the flower in which he had removed the stamen, so he could get the desired result. So cross-pollination or artificial cross-pollination was possible for Mendel in case of garden pea plant, and the garden pea plant was annual. That is why he could get results generation after generation very easily. Then it was convenient because it was easy to cultivate. So these are the points due to which Mendel chose his experimental plant as Spicum sativum, or the garden pea plant, or you can say edible pea plant.